Fibrid is, it's a comforting food.
Yeah, really just a delicious piece of bread that you can eat for, that's real quick.
Mutton sandwich.
And another one.
And prickly pear.
This is my bread and butter. It's a grab and go. A lot of people just kind of hang around here. I used to sit around and watch my mom make the dough and stuff. Oh, I wasn't cooking, I was just watching her and because I was always hungry.
Every tribe or maybe every family has a different way to make fry bread. Our fry bread is a lot different than the other vendors around here. Kneading the bread, putting your good thoughts into it, that's the most important ingredient, like soul food.
Corn, beans, and squash. That's basically our staple. Fry bread didn't come around until like after we came back from the long walk.
We're not talking about the Native American cultural foods. How much of it is it really cultural versus not cultural? And there's a huge debate now. The storyline is, you know, the white people took our cattle, our horses, our livestock. We have to resort to what we call that food distribution program. Canned foods, powdered substance, powdered eggs, powdered milk. You know, we weren't given recipes. We knew how to farm, we knew how to hunt. I can only imagine that they had to play with it. It has really brought many negatives in general to our health. It was a common thing at our table side. It's what I know, it's what I was raised on. I was raised on the notation that fry bread is the best thing to have for three times a day. It's comforting because anything we eat when we were younger, yeah, we go back to it as we get older. We probably relied on the government food distribution for a number of reasons. It's something I'm trying to reverse in my mind and remind not only myself, but remind my children, you know, cultural food is not a part of what we call Navajo fry bread.
Thank you guys for serving the way you guys do. I'll stay up, man. Good seeing you out.